Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to the channel. My name is Prestige, and today I want to talk about this absolutely humongous update that came to Call of Duty World War II yesterday and into the late hours of last night. There was a final update that crushed the Division Prestige glitch. I don't know if you guys have heard about this. We'll talk a little bit more about it in this video. And it sent out rolling bans. We got some nerfs to the bar, which we've talked about in a previous video, and a whole bunch of other quality of life improvements, including a brand new change to the headquarters and how it operates and functions. So, with that said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let us begin by talking about the changes to the headquarters, because you've probably noticed this right away. Instead of just getting loaded into the headquarters right away, you now actually have to select that from the multiplayer menu. This will place you inside of a headquarters where you can do everything that you've done before, including opening up supply drops, participating in the firing range, doing 1v1s, commending other players, and of course, taking up operations and orders from the Major himself. You can also collect your mail still. So everything is still intact. You can party up here. You can go ahead and start a multiplayer match from here, but you are no longer required to hop directly into the HQ if you don't want to go there, which is really cool. You're also no longer required to open up supply drops within the headquarters. So if you go to your menu and you open them up from there, you will be in this separate screen away from everybody where you can open up your supply drops in peace if you feel like you want to do that. The biggest downside to this, though, since you're not technically always in the HQ, after you complete a multiplayer match, you're no longer placed in an HQ automatically. You have to actually leave the match you're in to go back to the headquarters, and that kind of sucks, because if you're playing with a five-man team, and let's say you get a supply drop or two, and you wanted to open those up, or you wanted to collect new orders from the Major, you actually have to leave what you're doing in that specific game mode in order to go back to the HQ. You can't just do it in one foul swoop right away. I'm assuming they're going to remedy this by allowing people to access the Major from their start menu without actually going back to the HQ, but if you have to do orders or open up supply drops or anything that has to do with trying to earn some sort of social score, you're not going to be able to do that unless you completely leave the multiplayer menu and go into the HQ. That kind of sucks too, because if you find a really good lobby of people who are just, well, let's face it, downright easy and easy to get kills on, you're gonna have to leave that lobby if you want to do anything in the headquarters. So that's the only downside to this update. So let's move forward and talk about the bans that are happening for people who did the Point Du Hoc glitch, as well as people who did the glitch to get Prestige Master. So first things first, Point Du Hoc. From what I'm hearing, people that did that and ended up getting caught, they got a 48-hour ban. I don't know if this is going to result in a complete stat wipe. I'm not exactly sure. The 48-hour ban is still currently going on for those people. As for the folks who did the Prestige Master glitch, well, they're going to be getting a 72-hour ban and a complete stat reset, meaning they're going to have to start back from level 1, no Prestige. And I find that kind of fitting. Now, this is a glitch that I purposefully did not talk about here on the channel. When I first found out about it, I just kind of kept my mouth shut. I didn't want people to keep going through and doing this because I knew bans would be sent out if you did. The Prestige glitch happened in the HQ between the Division's commander and the General, where you do your normal Prestige. There was a small little thing that you're able to do to basically trick the game into thinking you were ready to Prestige, and you could literally get Prestige 10 or Prestige Master in the matter of 5 minutes, and it was actually pretty fucked up how easy it was to do. But let's move forward with all the other stuff that affects the multiplayer directly. As we all know, the bar received another nerf. We spoke about this briefly, and they did increase the recoil just a little bit. With the foregrip, you can still see that there's a pretty decent amount of recoil. It's still a very deadly weapon, though. I probably would expect to see this weapon get another nerf, simply because I know people are still going to complain about it. We also had a change to Primed this time around. We didn't have a change to the global flinch reduction, but Primed has been reduced by almost 85%. At least that's what Michael Condry said. And I think that there's more testing coming out from other people who have been using Primed. I've purposely avoided this perk because I didn't want to really rely on it as a crutch perk, but I guess we'll see exactly what happens moving forward. And while we're on the topic of weapon changes, let's talk about the fix that came to the STG-44 as well as a couple of the sniper rifles. If you've tried to use the red dot campsite, you know that you weren't unlocking reticles, and that's because for some reason, the 4x scope and the red dot sight had their challenges reversed. So while you were using the red dot sight, you were unlocking reticles for the 4x sight, and while you were using the 4x sight, you were unlocking reticles for the red dot sight, which is very confusing, but that's been fixed now, and reticles have also been fixed for the Kar 98 and the Lee Enfield. One of the biggest updates I would like to talk about beyond the map exploits is the fact that they fixed the snaking exploit. Now, this has been a problem since Call of Duty 4, hell, even since before that, since proning has been a thing. If you drop to prone and get up really quickly, you can actually stay on the ground. So your hitboxes are all on the ground, but you're actually shooting from up above. And it kind of makes it to where the enemy's shooting you on the ground, they're actually shooting your feet, when in reality it looks like they're shooting your head. It's a very confusing process, but apparently this has been fixed. I've seen a couple of people trying to take advantage of snaking still, but unfortunately, it just didn't work out for them. It worked out for me, because I was able to see exactly where the face was and get a headshot. Super easy on that one. Anyway, they also fixed a bunch of different weird problems that people have been experiencing since day one. Not being able to collect specific contracts, not being able to complete orders, or even retrieve mail from the mail carrier. I know my friend yesterday was just able to pick up his Divisions pack after this update came through, so for those of you that were missing all of your pre-order bonuses and you haven't been able to pick them up, you should be able to now. I also think this may have fixed the issue with getting higher social rank. A lot of people have been reporting that they haven't been able to actually get their rewards when they hit a new social rank, which is kind of strange. Now, I'm not saying that this is happening to everybody. I know that this is happening to some people out there, but I'm not sure how you're going to actually get those back. Maybe after the fact, they're going to put them in the mail carrier and you can pick up all of your items there. Maybe you'll be able to find your weapons in some other way, or maybe they're just going to be patched in once it realizes what level you are. But those things are supposed to be applied automatically. You don't receive them in a supply drop or anything, you just automatically get them. They also fixed one of my biggest complaints while playing with a party, the black screen of death. After a match, normally what would happen is you're supposed to go to your after action report, see everything, and go on your merry little way if you wanted to. But I think since it was paired with the headquarters, and not everybody was getting put inside of the same exact headquarters, this was preventing players from jumping back with their party, giving them a never-ending black screen until the game resumed, or until the next match started. Now after this HQ change, people aren't getting the black screen anymore. I played with a party yesterday, and I didn't have any issues whatsoever. I have seen people saying that there are still some buggy issues happening in the after action report, like XP consistently going over and over again, but not actually giving you more XP. It's kind of a weird noise to make. I don't really know Okay, you know what I'm trying to say. And I don't know if you guys have noticed this as well, but ever since the HQ has been completely removed from the multiplayer aspect of the game, I feel like connections have been more solid. Being able to get into multiplayer matches faster, and then of course being able to leave them faster to have more time to customize whatever class I want or open up supply drops in the middle there. But like I said at the beginning, the only downside to this is if you want to complete another order, you're going to have to back out of that match in order to go back to the HQ. But I'm sure that that will be resolved in the future. The final thing I want to talk about is a little controversial, I guess you could say, especially for the hardcore community. They made a change to paratroopers in the hardcore mode, and they reduced their overall health to have the same amount of health as a hardcore player. Now, I completely understand why they did this, because before they were a little bit powerful, but then again, we're talking about a very high tier streak. I thought that they were supposed to have that amount of health because it was a streak. But apparently they weren't supposed to have that amount of health. Just like in the core game modes, they have the same amount of health as a normal player, they carried over that same amount of health to the hardcore modes. Now, when I think of a streak, I want it to last a little bit, and I want it to get more than a couple of kills. Now with a paratrooper that has a lot less health, they can die within two bullets. That to me just seems like a worthless streak at this point. There was a little bit of reason to use it because you did have a little extra health and you had the opportunity to actually get kills with it in hardcore, but now it just seems like maybe you'll get one or two kills on unsuspecting players and that's where it's going to end right there. I think it's always going to be a controversial subject, but I think that paratroopers need to come in with some sort of body armor to prevent them from dying in the first few shots of a gunfight. And in hardcore, that's just completely all but lost. you think about it this way. A paratrooper is only going to see you for a certain amount of distance. If you're one side of the map and he's on the other on a Gustav cannon or something like that, you're going to be able to pick him off in two bullets or maybe even possibly one bullet with a headshot in hardcore before they even have an opportunity to do anything. Now think about this as well. Do they bear the same amount of health coming down from the plane, or do they have less health in their parachutes, meaning they can be shot out before they even get to the map? This is where the controversy begins. I don't really know what else to say about all of that, but if you guys would like to see the entire list, once again, we only covered a small sliver here. I wanted to talk about the main stuff that you're going to notice for yourself in-game. The full list can be found in the description of this video. If you guys enjoyed, take a moment of your time, click that like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. And until tomorrow, my friends, I'll see ya. Peace.